Good afternoon, students. Welcome to the online session of Biology for Engineers. In today's session, we'll start with Unit 4, Human Diseases. In our last session, we have completed Unit 3, Genetics and Evolution. Now we will be starting the Unit 4, Human Diseases. In this unit, fourth unit, Human Diseases, you will be studying about the different types of diseases like diabetes, influenza, cancer, hepatitis. In this unit, you will learn about the different types of diseases, what is the main cause of a particular disease, what are the symptoms and how to prevent different types of diseases to human beings, and how our immune system is fighting against the disease causing organisms, and how the different types of vaccines is helping in prevention of diseases to human beings, how the vaccines are helping in prevention of diseases, you will be studying in this unit. So you will learn the different concepts related to the diseases, human diseases, in Unit 4. As you know, all the organs and the organ systems should function properly in a healthy human body. If all the organs and organ systems are not functioning properly, then the patient is said to have a disease. If the organ or organ systems of a healthy body is not functioning properly, then the patient is said to be having a disease. So different types of disease is affecting the human beings. In this unit, you will be studying about some important diseases like diabetes, the first one here, what we are studying here is diabetes. Diabetes The term diabetes was coined by the Greek physician. Diabetes means to pass through. Diabetes is a disease characterized by increase in blood sugar levels. So diabetes is a disease which is characterized by increase in blood sugar levels or increase in blood glucose levels. Insulin, which is the main hormone which is produced by the pancreas, an organ near stomach, which is making this insulin, will help glucose get absorbed into the cells of our body. So when you have this diabetes, that insulin will not help the cells of our bodies to absorb the sugars. Then what will happen? The sugars will build up in the blood. That is why many people is calling this diabetes, commonly we call it as sugar. So in the diabetes, the body will not properly process the food. If the properly food is not processed, then energy will not be produced. So most of the food we eat, it will turn into the glucose or the sugars for our bodies to give us energy. Then due to this diabetes, which is characterized by increase in blood sugar levels. So insulin is the main hormone here, which is playing a very significant role in the occurrence of this diabetes. The disease may be due to insulin deficiency or the inability of the body to utilize the insulin, and glucose synthesis in the body is increased due to this diabetes. Causes, the main causes of diabetes. We have here two types of diabetes, type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. The main cause of diabetes here, when pancreatic cells is damaged, as the pancreas is producing the insulin, when the cells in the pancreas will get damaged, then that will lead to deficiency of insulin. Deficiency of insulin or the type 1 diabetes, destroying the cells in the pancreas. When the cells in the pancreas are destroyed, then there will be deficiency of insulin. As the pancreas is producing the insulin, cells are getting destroyed, then the pancreas are not producing the insulin. So there is deficiency of insulin in type 1 diabetes, as the cells in the pancreas are destroyed or damaged. Infections caused by viruses may also lead to, viral infections may also lead to diabetes. Causes, viral infections, bacterial infections may also lead to diabetes. It may be also a cause of diabetes. Increased chemical toxins within the food may also be the cause. This can also be the cause of the diabetes. Then we have type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes, it may be due to relative insulin deficiency or resistance of both. The disease, this type 2 disease, will progress to such an extent that it will require external supply of insulin in order to maintain blood glucose level. So next we have symptoms, signs and symptoms associated with the type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes are frequent urination, excessive thirst, unexplained weight loss, extreme hunger, sudden vision changes, numbness in hands or feet, feeling very tired much of the time, nausea, vomiting, stomach pains may accompany some of these symptoms in the abrupt onset of insulin dependent diabetes. Now we call it as type 1 diabetes. Next we have diagnosis. Different diagnostic center are performing different procedures or the test or the process, like fasting blood glucose level or A1C. A1C here is the hemoglobin A1C protein, hemoglobin A1C. It will measure, this A1C will measure how much sugar is attached to blood hemoglobin protein. A1C will measure by the diagnostic centers. This is a process of diagnosis. It is measuring how much sugar is attached to blood hemoglobin protein. Then we have OGTT, oral glucose tolerance test. Then random blood glucose test. Then we have the treatment and prevention of the diabetes. How to treat and prevent the disease diabetes? By changing the lifestyle, eating healthy food, increasing physical activity will reduce the type 2 diabetes and it will also control the type 1 diabetes. So lifestyle changes can minimize the other risk factors such as high blood pressure and blood cholesterol, which will have a negative impact on people with diabetes. Next we have another disease, that is cancer. Next type of disease here is cancer. Cancer here will describe about the disease when cell will undergo continuous growth, cells or tissues will undergo continuous growth, and this continuous undifferentiated cells or tissues growth will spread to other sites of the body. Cancer is a group of disease involving abnormal cell growth. Cell or the tissues is growing abnormally. Excessive growth of the cell or the tissues of the body you can see in the cancer, and it is spreading to other sites of the body parts. This we also call it as tumors. Cancers are nothing but the tumors, benign tumors. Tumors are cancers. Benign tumors are not spreading to the other parts. Possible signs and symptoms include the lumps, abnormal bleeding, prolonged cough, unexplained weight loss, and a change in the bowel movements. So the term cancer here, it is a disease with excessive growth of cells, abnormal cell growth or abnormal tissue growth, and it is spreading to the other parts of the body also. We call it as tumors, cancers or the tumors. Causes, main cause of the cancer, some changes in the DNA within the cells. Change in the DNA of the cells, we call it as mutations. Changes in the DNA will be resulting in a disease called cancer. DNA inside the cell, DNA will have, we have seen, in the DNA we have individual genes. Genes, DNA will contain the genes, each of will perform a set of instructions telling the cell what functions to perform as well as how to grow and divide. The genes will be helping the body cells to function properly and how to grow and divide. So the changes in the genes, changes in the DNA, we call it as mutations. Changes in the DNA or the genes will be causing the disease cancer. Symptoms include the fatigue, lumps or area of thickening that can be felt under the skin, weight changes including intended loss or gain, skin changes such as yellowing, darkening or redness of the skin, sores that won't heal or changes to existing moles, changes in bowel or bladder habits, persistent cough or trouble breathing, difficulty swallowing, hoarseness, all these are the different symptoms of the disease cancer. Then diagnosis, cancer diagnosis is through the physical examination and a complete medical history. Laboratory studies of blood, urine, stool are detected, can be detected abnormalities that is leading to cancer. Tumor is nothing but cancer is suspected. Tests such as x-rays, computed tomography, CT, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, ultrasound, fiber optic endoscopy examinations helps doctors to determine the cancer's location and size. Treatment are different surgeries, radiation therapy, chemotherapy are done, immunotherapy to treat the cancer, hormone therapy, targeted therapy, stem cell transplant, precision medicines are the different procedures done for the treatment of cancer. Then prevention of cancer, how to prevent the disease is stop smoking, avoid excessive sun exposure, eat a healthy diet, exercise most days of the week, maintain a healthy weight, schedule cancer screening exams, ask your doctors about immunizations. So these are the different diseases. First one we have studied about the diabetes, and the second what we have studied in today's session is cancer. Diabetes and cancer definition, causes, signs and symptoms, treatment, diagnosis, prevention, all this you need to study about the diabetes and cancer in the human diseases. So, thank you students. In next class, we'll continue with the unit 4, human diseases. Next type of disease we will study.